conversations this afternoon will focus on the very disciplines that often are not spoken of in terms of America's competitiveness. And while the Commission embraces the core value of the humanities to having a sense of empathy, a sense of oneself, a sense of our place in the universe through reading of philosophy and literature and history, we also are going to make a somewhat more instrumental argument about the civil life of this country and abroad. The Academy has been working in this field since its founding in 1780, when we already set as a task advancing the humanities and social sciences and science as what this nation was going to need to compete then. And our early members of the Academy, early members of the Republic, made this argument in their writings. In a famous letter to his wife, Abigail, Adams wrote, "I must study politics and war that our sons may have liberty to study mathematics and philosophy. Our sons ought to study mathematics and philosophy, geography, natural history, and naval architecture, navigation, commerce, and agriculture, in order to give their children a right to study painting, poetry, music, architecture, statuary, tapestry, and porcelain." And was not said, I think, in hierarchical order, but rather the liberty to study all fields of knowledge. The distinguished statesmen, scholars, soldiers, and students assembled here today represent in many ways a manifestation of John Adams' aspirations for humanistic inquiry and for the intellectual development of the country. We have invited some of you to offer initial thoughts to help frame the conversation, but I know John and I intend for this group to participate actively as a whole in the discussion. I hope we can reserve a few minutes at the very end of the meeting to discuss ways that you think the Commission can help advance the ideas that emerge from the conversation.